bathroom time. Bathroom time! Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Ed here, JH and Sons Landscaping. If you like the content, please like and subscribe. It's Friday. It's kind of chilly out right now, but I think it's supposed to get up into the mid-70s. We had to stop this morning. Shayne had to go to the bathroom. So we have yet to start. But we should be able to get it all done today. I hope. I'll take you guys with me somewhere along the way. All right. Hey guys, so just a little update. I haven't been filming too much today because Shayne got sick and had to go home, and Anthony had the day off today. So it's just me and Jim, my dad, cutting today, and we're feeling it a little bit. We're a couple hours behind, so we'll see what we can get done. Not having that extra couple hands really makes a big difference. So I'm gonna try and record a little bit for you guys at this section that we're at, and we'll see how it goes. See, and like, that's why I hate sycamore trees. All year, sycamore trees. I hate them. They're the worst. The worst trees. Look, the mess that they leave. In the whole neighborhood. From these sycamore trees. And it's like that all year. So, they're the worst. Have I said that enough? Let me grab my hearing protection and we'll get on with this. Guys, we got baby bunnies. Let's just see if there's any more. Yep, there we go. I'll have to be extra careful, make sure that I don't hit any of them. I was lucky because I didn't even see them. Hey guys, so Anthony decided to show up, which is a surprise. I didn't think he would come this late in the day, but hey, the more hands the better. So yeah, I ran into a rabbit's nest on that yard that I didn't see. I didn't see it, and luckily I didn't hurt any of the rabbits. They just flew out of nowhere. That nest was hidden pretty well, so yeah, lucky. Three rabbits. So I'll just keep an eye out for the next week or so when we come back. Make sure we don't hurt any rabbits, but I think they'll be gone by the next time. So I'm gonna move on. We didn't end up finishing our work. We still have 6 jobs left for the week. Maybe 7. So it was kind of a weird day, because in the morning Shayne got sick and he had to go home, and then me and Jim, my father-in-law, worked together for most of the day. And then Anthony, I was surprised that Anthony came so late. It was I want to say about 4 o'clock when he showed up, and he worked with us. We stopped. It's almost 7 o'clock right now, so he worked with us for a couple hours to try and get the work done. But we're gonna work for a couple hours tomorrow, and we'll finish up. But it was nice that he came to help us out, because we wouldn't have been able to get as far as we got with just the two of us. So sometimes that happens, you know, one of your guys isn't feeling good. And he tried to come to work this morning, but it was just too much for him. So we took him home. So we're gonna work tomorrow and try and get the six or seven jobs that we missed today done, and we'll move on with our lives, and hopefully Shayne will feel better, and we'll get into the next week after that. So we only have what, maybe like four or five weeks left of grass cutting. And really, like, I'm surprised the leaves are starting to drop and the trees are starting to change colors. It seems a little bit early for that. Usually, and today was pretty chilly out. Right now, me being in a t-shirt, I'm actually kind of cold. So it's kind of, I think it feels like early for leaves to be dropping already, but they're starting to change colors, man. And we'll, once the leaves start dropping, we'll be, because in our area that our township does, well, a few of the townships in our area do leaf collections, where they come around with a big vacuum and you're allowed to put piles of leaves in the street at during certain times of the year, and the vacuum will come and they'll take those piles away. So our first collection is usually right around Halloween, and I think throughout the years we might have had a couple of seasons that were early enough with leaves to put leaves out for the first collection. I think this year we will most likely be putting leaves out for the first collection, so we'll see how that goes. But usually we don't get too busy with leaves until like maybe the week before Thanksgiving. It's pretty busy with leaves, so we'll see if Halloween comes around and there's a lot of leaves. Usually as the leaves drop, we'll keep cutting the grass, and then because our township collects the leaves, we just blow the leaves that are in the front yard out to the curb, and we will just mulch the leaves on the in the backyard, or like, but once the leaves get too thick and heavy, we stop cutting the grass. So if we feel as though the yard needs a leaf cleanup, then we won't cut. So and for those of you guys out there that just mulch the leaves up without getting your leaf cleanups in, that's a mistake, because you know, your leaf cleanups for an average job for us is probably like $120, between $120 and $150 for a leaf cleanup. And you know, if you're chopping up those leaves every single time you go to cut, then your customer's not gonna want a leaf cleanup. So you need to sell those leaf cleanups and try and get those along with your cutting. So you still want to keep cutting, but you want to get those leaf cleanups, you know. So when it gets too thick, you want to sell those leaf cleanups and just let them know that it's too much for your mower to cut, and to cut the grass, then I need to do a leaf cleanup. So I know there's guys out there that chop them up for nothing, and you just chop them up and you just cut the grass, and you put a lot of wear and tear on your equipment for nothing, and then the customer doesn't care, and you're putting wear and tear on your equipment, and then you're missing out on that leaf cleanup. So you want to really try and get those leaf cleanups when you can. So yeah, I'll stop talking now, but I'll see you guys in the next one.